the bridle, because he's not good to sit on before he come down. I remember. Yep. Okay. All right. If you come up here, you stay very elastic. Good. So you see if you can bring him a little forward. Okay, try to let him change the rein again, so go over to left. Yeah, I really feel if perhaps you could help her with a marching gal or something.
Yeah, we did that a while, but at home she got him pretty like this.
Yes, okay, good.
Yeah, I think,
for now it's a new place and more to look at.
Yeah, exactly.
Because
it's pretty light for her, usually. Yes,
but because it's really the easiest.
Yeah.
Good, yep. Okay, good.
Yeah,
it's important you just take your time. So of course, when it's a new place,
exactly.
It's easier to lose it.
Yeah.
Good. Just a little forward, All right. And just when he's down, you try to push the tempo a little again. Yep. Push forward, So, good. Okay. And forward, So you respond for your legs. Yep. Okay, good. Exactly. So it's also from your forward, he come more down into your bridle. Yes. Good. Okay. So he just stay down here, even what you're doing. It's okay. I like better he go down here, even you get a little lower than we perhaps want. So it gives you a better feeling of control. Good. All right. So keep him in front of your legs. Pretty good. Or let him change the rein again. So you just keep your same tempo. Also a little outside, Right. So keep it in front of your legs. Good. Okay, and just go circle again. So we keep working on circles till he stay more steady round. Good. All right. So just keep it. Good. Right. Just forward, Pull him change the rein again. Just in the same tempo. So you can get him more in front of your legs. Good for inside leg, Try to go a little straight on your long side to bring him more forward. And if he come up over a bit, you go into your turn again. So you can get his attention. It's okay to tap him a little for your whip. Yep. Just forward. So good. And then the contact again. Right. Oh, pretty good. Keep it. Keep it. Yep. All right. That good. So you're right. So from inside leg can make your circle a little bigger. So keep him forward. Good. Okay, it's okay to go to walk and take a little break. Good. No, we just talk about, perhaps he's easier at home.
Uh-huh.
And then here he loses a little attention on other things. And so of course he's making it a little harder.
Uh-huh.
You just need to have patience and keep going to get something.
Yeah.
So he starts to give more and more up in the neck, and where you go after to really bring him in front of your legs.
Right.
So, and I like better he go too low than he come up.
Right.
For if he come up, you can feel so you have no back to sit on, and so he's away from you. If he's really down, too much down, so you still have your back and you have still some more control. So it's a lot better he come down. Also, even if it's too far, but so you know where you have your horse.
That's true.
Yep. And from the air, so you can sort of improve to see if you first have him steady, over round, then you can bring him a little higher because so you have your control. But you must first know where you have him. But his attention a little outside. And yet it's important you give him something to think about. So just tell him you're sitting on him and ride him, so he concentrates on you. Yeah. Okay, we're just walking forward again, and then you go to, you okay yourself?
Yeah,
Yeah, we just start off with some odd sort work.
Okay. He's fitted in a horse.
Okay, that's good. That's good.
Yeah.
Every time you feel where he gets too high, you flex him a little, bend him a little. It's important you do something. Try to take a little inside rein. Don't be too nice. Touch his mount. You're too nice, yeah? Tell him to bending more. So yeah, good. And your legs. And a little again. Right? Try to change your bending a little. Left, right, left, right. It's okay. And then right. Move his neck a little bit.
Okay.
Yep, and lift. A little right and lift. A little quicker. And do it a little more. Yep. And use your legs. It's okay. Right? Okay, good. And then go trot again. Good. It's okay. Yep. And direct you go after to get your contact and stay very elastic so you move his neck a little bit. In your forward. Yeah, good. So you can get him down. Right. Yep. Okay. Good. And keep it. Keep him forward. For both legs. Okay. Good. And keep his attention. So you're not looking at the other horse. Keep going. Oh, good. So, yeah. Just still forward, yeah. Good. Well, next time, so just let him change the rein. So you better you have him, then you change more and more often. So you're working both sides. Good. Right, try to bend him a little inside. Flex him a little in your fingers. Good, so you get inside bending. Yep, good, okay, and keep it, yep, good, okay. Eat what we want, he stay there, even where you're riding in your ring, so he gets steady, yep, and keep it in front of your legs, yeah. Right, every time she's on your way up, you have to fix it before you lose him. All right. Good. Okay. So you feel he likes to coming down. Very good. And keep it. Touch him a little for your whip. All right. Because now it's important your horse don't let you work too hard. Yeah, your horse have to help you. So moving forward, try to let him change the rein again. Good. Just forward and down. Oh, good. So just make a big soft turn, so change the rein again. Keep moving, yep. Good, and get left bending. So you can get his shoulder, and from your shoulder get his neck. So push from inside leg. So you can keep his attention. Right. Good. All right. Good. Push a little forward, yeah. Try to touch him for your whip. Yep. One more time, so you come more forward. Yep. So you also can start to make a little difference in your tempo. Okay, and get his neck a little again. Okay. Right, really round. Open, close your fingers. Good. Okay. Yeah, right. Easy way you make him better in the trot. It's okay to go walk. Good. You feel easy way you make him better in the trot. Down and then forward. And it was make it so he get easier and nicer to sit.
Yeah.
Because so he's pushing from your hind legs, you start to get a better swing in the back because it come out and down here. Are you ready for some candor?
Yeah. You need a sip of drink? You need water with
No, not really.
You need some air?
No, you so, no, you're pretty fit.
Yeah, I'm pretty fit.
Yeah, it's fine.
Okay.
So we just go again, and then they try to go kind of a walk. I think it's the easiest.
Yes. Yeah. And she's done that. She knows.
I just have to hang on to this part of
it. Yeah, that's okay.
Yeah, one hand only.
Yeah.
So good.
One hand.
Yeah.
And you just get him round in the walk, and don't be too nice. He's a big, strong animal, and if you not tell him what he shall do, he do his own things.
Okay.
Yep. Good. So he can get his neck down. Yep. Fix him a little, yeah. And make a small turn. Try to make a very small circle. And turn him, yep. And walking. Walk forward. Use your legs. Give him a kick. Yep. Don't be too nice. Yep. Good. I get it, yeah. Do something. You need to make something happen. Yep. So okay. Good. It's okay. And then you do the same to right. I really feel that's good for you to do. And touch him for the whip. So, oh yeah. Okay. So you're not walking around where he stay up, because so you cannot get the canter transition.
Yeah.
Good. Yep. Move your fingers a little bit. Yeah, inside leg, yeah. So you get a little softer on right rein. Open, close your fingers a little, yeah. So, good. So you can get your inside shoulder. Right. Good. Try to change the rein again. So go over to left. And so you come down, yeah. Good. I feel that try to start with your left canter first. So just make it turn bigger. Good. And you're just sitting back, yeah? Good, just come. Okay, good. That's fine. Okay. It's fine enough when you have it.
Yeah.
You shall just keep it.
Do you have any tips for me? I help with a whip, lunge whip.
Right.
And he's okay with that. Do you have any other tips that she can keep him going a little easier?
You have a whip in your hand?
Yeah.
Try using.
On the outside?
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, when you feel he starts to be drop your canter, touch him a little. You don't need to really hit him, but just touch him a little bit, because of course we can help you from the ground, but I really don't feel you need it.
No.
I really feel you shall just ask for a little more. Good. Yeah. That's fine. Good. Okay. And you have to feel how much whip you need. Yeah, good. All right.
The first time she can't just put a whip.
Good. It's okay. It's okay. And how much you shall use it is depend of what your horse are doing.
Yeah.
So if he starts to get more and more power, so you of course don't use your whip.
Right.
But if you feel he get more and more heavy, close to drop your canter, then you shall see and you can fix it before you lose it.
Yeah, and I'm not good at feeling that.
No, but it's coming if you practice. You have to, your goal is your half of your right have to be canter. Yep. Good. Oh, not too much now. Oh, good. Okay.
No.
It's okay. Too late. Yeah, it's okay. Try to change the rein and go over. Do the same to right.
Okay.
He's ready. And yeah. Oh, relax, relax. He's not lazy.
No. Not
oh, now, not too much whip. Oh, be careful with your whip now. And okay, and stop him, and walk. I feel you need your whip outside. Yeah, or I can take him. But now he's wake up, and then of course you're not using your whip. But if you use have your whip in your hand, I feel it's good to have it outside. Because when you're turning, it's easy to come towards him.
And I'm not good at using it yet.
No, but use it outside the hand.
For canter.
So it's easier to control it.
Yeah.
It's okay, yeah, get him round, yeah. You try to left, right, yeah. Good, and right. He's ready?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, good. That's fine. Relax a little. It's important you not lose control. Yep, canter. Good. Canter. Okay. That's okay. Take a little trot. We'll get him really down.
Okay.
all the way down to the ground with your nose.
Okay.
Right. Some Dutch writing. Yeah. That's good.
we're in trouble.
I like it.
Yeah, you do.
Oh, yeah.
We're in big trouble, huh?
Yeah. So now you need to control him. Many small, quick inside. Control the tempo. So just relax. Okay. And a little contact there. Try to keep him. Yeah, and change the rein. Right. Good. And be careful, not too long reins. All right. Just relax. Keep contact to his mount. Right. Okay. Pretty good. And it's okay to just go walk there. I really feel that now with the canter work, when you first start to get it on this way, so it's a very good way to learn to keep canter. You tell yourself, now I make four circles in canter, and you really make four. You have to go and set four circles, or perhaps three.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And then when you can do that, so you say, okay, next time I take five circles, uh-huh. six, seven, eight, uh-huh. ten, and then you keep going.
Yeah.
If you pick a number in this way, so you go more for it.
Yeah.
And said you have to keep it as on what you have planned. Mm-hmm.
I
feel it's a good way
to
start to get it, you know.
Yeah.
And your goal is, your half of your right is canter.
Okay.
Not tomorrow, but one day.
Yeah. Well, maybe day after tomorrow.
Yeah. Exactly. I really feel most riders feel it's easier to sit in canter.
I like
yeah,
cancer. I do like
it. I really feel if you first train it more and more, so it gets easier and easier.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Before you both to get it and control it, and so you also come to sitting more.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you too.
It was really fun.
Okay.
You look really good. You look really good.
You. Me?
Yes.
Did I look good?
You look much healthier than you did.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. No, but I really feel fine.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Right. Sometimes we have more busy times than others.
Yeah, yeah.
So.
Yeah, yeah.
But thank you very much.
You like compliments.
Oh, yeah.